Do you like murder and do you like revenge and building simulators? You do? Okay. That's great. This is School of the Lamb. It's a game. You just build silly structures and go on adventures. It's really silly indeed. And it makes me go silly. Not gonna lie. If I added a new update a while back, then like 2 days ago, and they added a it was called Sins of the Flesh. And that's the name of the update, which adds a tailoring, brewing stations, and mating tents. So you can literally like, there are families in this game now. In this video, I will just be doing stuff like this. I think the game is like this. Them. Someone go cook. Perfect. Another thing about this game is you can do rituals. You can get married or something. Maybe you can kill someone or you can bring someone from the dead. That is pretty cool, I'd say. Let's marry these dudes in this quest. I've played a little bit of this update so far, and it is the update of all time. It is the update of all time. Eat. Make your goat brainwashed. Make someone the most loyal disciple, and you can sacrifice someone to the leap, and you can give money, and you can take money, and there's more. But I don't have much unlocked. Maybe someone go cook. Oh wait. Oh. They can't cook because, yeah, they're off work. I'm gonna go for them instead. Hope it's poisonous. Let me claim a quest for me. Yo. Which is more for dungeons. Yippee. Someone died at the cult, but it's okay. We will take care of it later. This is a game mode. The optional game mode to say. And you get god tears from it. The god tears make you I'll just say they make you basically give them god. It gives you random items. So that's pretty cool. Your normal health, but you can't roll. You have, but you can't use weapons. And you can only use spells, which I have right now. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Actually, recorded first, we actually just the thing is, the mic fucking sucks. It's the worst thing that you could ever do. And it is because I wanted to play with the control block, did I? Now the quality isn't as good as before I even tried to record it. I'm going to take. So yeah, this is Anchor Deep, which is the location. Let's go with Darth Guard. Literally vampirism. Second part of the story. The main boss. Thank you.
Oh shit!
That's good. So yeah, this unlocks after you beat the main story. So you give them this god and he spins the wheel for you. So this is like a full of the silly rabbit. Do you have another one? Please give me you two. Yes. I'm gonna go show this off right now. It's a Forgotten Commandment Stone. Basically, it is. Basically, you can at the temple, at the ground, you can do doctrines, which are pretty much upgrades to the cult. You can murder followers, or you can ascend a follower, you can do weddings, you can do leaf and absolution, loyalty enforcer, everything like that, everything money related. That's what the Forgotten Doctrine is for. Sect of Wrath leader to receive sin. Followers feast. Oh god. Oh. What's the right? Night time, so first thing I'm gonna do is do a breath of mini game. Let's go. Take the sin out of him. Go sleep. And that is pretty much the game. It's pretty much. Alright, so hi guys. This is a little bit later. I'm recording this a little bit later. And I just built myself a level 2 dream house. And show you guys this. Unless you hack it. Oh god. Never mind. I'll do this. See if they're locked. We won't be loud enough. Dr. Sazonius. Oh. We saved him. It's your old man. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe.